day. I'm hungry and I'm ready for change. I run too far to still be the same. See who I was, I give him away. Today, today. No longer bound by what people say. I know that I will make mistakes. I fall, but I refuse to stay. Today.
I've been waiting all my life to get to the door. Someone see their life for so much more.
Today we go. Thinking how much more of this can I take? In a minute I'm about to break. Today, see the pain has purpose, so don't throw it away. There's a harvest if you only wait. Don't walk out now, I need you to stay. Today.
Though you never felt winds blow like this before. So much more.
Today we go. I felt my last drop of rain. I believe I'm gonna be okay. Today, see today.
Today
I'm still here because of my faith. I believe that Jesus still is the way. I said his name cause I'm not afraid. Today.
Woo!
Channels Television's breaking news.
You better ask somebody.
The Union District Baptist Association is hosting 200 men in black and women in white. On Monday, it's Women's Night, May 6th at 6 p.m. On Tuesday, May 7th at 6 p.m., it's Men's Night. The host church will be 8th Street Baptist Church, where the pastor is Jamel Wesley.
Good morning, First Baptist family. Summer is right around the corner, and what better way is there for your children to spend their summer than with Christ? The First Baptist Church Chilling with Christ summer program applications are available at this time, so go ahead and register your kids today. This year, we are accepting volunteers as young as 13 years old. And if you'd like to help out with the camp yourself, all donations are welcomed. For more info, you can see Sister Alicia Johnson in the Main Street Foyer. Have a good day, First Baptist.
As May is vastly approaching and graduations are in bloom, if your youth is graduating, please let me know so that we can recognize them here at First Baptist on such a grand accomplishment. Lastly, June 3rd through the 4th, CMBC, Congress of Christian Education Baptist Youth Fellowship, that was a lot, right? BYF, presents A Homecoming Fully Committed, featuring a youth explosion. Let's show up and show out this year as the youth of First Baptist Church, Main Street. See me, Ms. Tracy, or text me at 501-650-6887. Thank you.
Become a prayer warrior and remember those on our special prayer list during your quiet time with...
Hey, amen. Good morning. It's a blessing to be here. It's a good morning. God has blessed us all to come back and see one another again. It's a good morning. I know that the weather is looking a little ominous outside. The clouds are coming in. But as our pastor constantly reminds us, even though the S-U-N may not be shining on the outside, the S-O-N is shining bright on the inside. So we give praise for the S-O-N shining bright this morning. We worship him this morning. Come on and stand to your feet. We're so excited to be here and just praise his name. How many of you know he's a way maker? Do you know him as a miracle worker? How about as a promise keeper? Does somebody know him as light in the darkness? That is who he is. He's here in the midst of us. He's here right now when we worship you, oh God. We worship you this morning, Lord. We praise and lift your holy name. We recognize that you are here. And we reverence you, oh God.
Oh,
God, you are.
Waymaker. Miracle worker.
Thank you, God.
Not a light, but the light. In the midst of our dark, depressing, discouraging situations, that's what God is. Waymaker. I just want to know, has anybody known him to be a waymaker today? Don't fool me now. If he made a way out of no way, you ought to give the Lord the praise. Why? Because he's worthy. Somebody said, from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. And hallelujah, he didn't stop right there. But then somebody said, he's a miracle worker. When they kicked you to the curb and thought you weren't even worth to live or die, he's a miracle worker. When family members turn their backs on you for the last time, he's a miracle worker. People saw you go down for the last time. They didn't see you come back up, but he's a... My God, my God. Waymaker. Miracle worker. Light in the darkness. That's who he is. And today, if you have not realized that, you're in the right place at the right time. Because he wants to make himself alive to you today. So let us go to God in prayer and see just how he's able to do the impossible, the unthinkable, how he specializes in the undoable. Why? Because he's our God. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for this day. Thank you for dangers seen and unseen, for watching over us in the midnight hour. Thank you, Father, for being a waymaker who makes ways when we feel like life has given up on us. You made a way. When our finances have been funny, you made a way. When family members have left us to the side, you made a way. When we lost our jobs and people have turned their backs on us, Lord, you still made a way. Then you didn't stop right there. But Lord, you still, in 2024, you're still able to work a miracle. The reason why I know you're able to work a miracle, because every day when I look into the mirror, I see a miracle looking back at me. I know that it was by your mercy and by your grace that I'm able to be here just one more time to give you praise. Why? Because you're worthy to be praised. You found some of us when we were in the muck and the miry clay, when we were not fit to live, when we were not fit to die, but you are a miracle worker. So we pause and we take a moment to just say thank you. Thank you for loving us when sometimes we couldn't even know how to love ourselves. Thank you for when we couldn't see the day breaking and when we couldn't even handle the midnight hour. You were there all the time, holding us and carrying us through the valley of the shadow of death. Thank you for loving us and keeping us as only you can. Now, Father, we've come together collectively and individually to just worship you in spirit and in truth. Holy Spirit, we invite you to come right now and have a seat. Allow your spirit to run roughshod all over the sanctuary this morning, that you may touch us and let us know that there is still a reality in serving a true and living God. Oh, Father God, we thank you for loving us, Father, when we know we did wrong. Thank you for helping us to realize the wrong that we've done so that we can repent and turn back to you. Forgive us of our sins and our shortcomings. Forgive us of those times when we fail to love one another. Forgive us of those times when we fail to lift one another up instead of spending time tearing one another down. Forgive us, Lord. Give us a spirit of worship and praise. And we'll be forever mindful to praise you. Why? Because you're worthy to be praised. You're worthy because you first loved us. You're worthy because you gave your son to die for us. And then you're worthy because Jesus, one Sunday morning, you got up with all power in heaven and earth in your hand. And because you got up, we can get up from our sadness. We can get up from our sorrow. We can get up from our sickness. And Lord, we thank you for giving us the victory. Now, Father God, the man that comes to proclaim your word, give him power from on high to set the captives free through your word, to let a dying world know that there's still a reality in serving a true and living God, to let them know that they can go on just a little while longer, to let them know that they're not alone in the midnight hour, to let them know that they're not by themselves when they feel all alone, that you have your arms wrapped around them, because you love and care for us. Thank you, Father, for what you've done. Thank you for what you're doing right now. And we praise you for what you're yet to do. For eyes have not seen nor ears have heard what God has in store for them that are willing to do your will. These and many more things we ask it all in the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, amen.
I know that the angel, keep right on watching over me. My Lord, shake somebody's hand and tell them, it's a day. Come on, everybody, sing with all your heart. If you don't know it, come on, say, it's out there. Come on, say it if you love him. All day. What's happening? What's happening? I know that the angels, they keep watching. Say it like you love God and say, all day. Woo-hoo-hoo. I know that the angels, they keep watching over me.
Want to come to you today. Oh, how precious is the name of Jesus. Yeah. Amen. We praise God for Sister Frankie. She's been away, but we're glad to have her with us this morning. Come on and praise God this morning. Oh, how precious. Jesus. Lily of the valley, Jesus. Bright and morning sun, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to your name.
Amen. Come on, give God a hand of praise. Oh, how precious is the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless you. Listen, don't forget, amen, this Monday, on tomorrow, amen, all of our women who are available and able, we're asking you would meet us at the 8th Street Baptist Church, amen, 6 o'clock. For the 200 women in white, and especially on Tuesday, amen, all of our men, we are inviting you to join the men of our church, amen, as we go to the 8th Street Baptist Church at 6 o'clock on that Tuesday for the 200 men in black. So we do invite you to come be a part of both of those celebrations, amen. Listen, it's always a joy and honor to have special friends in the house, and we have a master sergeant in the house, amen. Brother Deshaun White, if you would stand, you and your lovely wife, amen. We went to UCA together. We're so happy to have him visiting with us. God bless you, Chief. Instructor, amen, for ROTC and all of that, amen. Great military personality. Thank you for your service, your friendship down through the years. And we're definitely happy, amen, once again, to have Sister and Reverend Johnson with us, amen. If they would stand, I want to invite both of them to stand. Amen. And they even got the little one with them today. Amen. The main man. He was a little old bitty boy. Amen. Last time we saw him. Amen. Thank God. Come on, Reverend. Amen. Reverend, you know, God has really blessed this young man. Humble start. And I don't hate on what God does in the life of other folks. I'm not like that. You know, it just gives me a great joy to know that I went to college with this young man. And I was there when he preached his first sermon. And we are out of the same home church, amen, Greater Second Baptist, and we've been friends down through the years. And he was honored, amen, by Arkansas Baptist College on yesterday, amen, with his doctorate of humane ladder, amen, ladders, amen. So we thank God that God is continuing to elevate him, started his own 501c3 institution, and we thank God for that and how he has elevated him. He's a colonel, amen. Lieutenant colonel? Colonel retired, amen. He has retired with all that military experience. He's working cyber now. He has a special presentation. I'm going to trust him. It's a good presentation he's going to make today. He said he wanted to do something, so I'm going to let him do it briefly, amen. Briefly, amen. We know him, don't we? We know him, y'all, don't we? Those of us who've been around, we know him briefly. Amen.
Amen. Giving honor to God, we thank you. Thank you, Pastor. You know, I said this yesterday during the graduation. You know, we were always taught, give the flowers while they can be, you know, appreciated. And so for this moment, just real quickly, I'm going to ask if Sister Tammy, if you could come, First Lady, and Pastor, if you could come down here. And my wife and I just want to give a token of appreciation. Baby, will you come and bring that? amen. Amen. Y'all give my blessing, my baby, my boo, a hand. No, you can. Okay. So here's real quickly, and I'm going to be obedient. I first came to this church, and I'm just going to be real with you for a minute. I was a pretty broken brother when I first came to y'all. Some of you probably had to lay hands and pray on me, but God placed me with this brother, this pastor, who we started preaching around the same time. Him, myself, and Reverend Graham, and you know, never would have known that I would have came this way. But when I came this way, this pastor nurtured me, gave me room to grow. I know I probably stressed him out a few times. But he was patient with me and gave me room to blossom. They tell you to bloom where you're planted. And God blessed and planted me here with you. And not only that, but you as a church, put your arms of love, Sister Jean, everyone, put their arms of love around me. And here's the result of your return. So I'm not going to go down the accolades of what God has done. Not so much me, but what God has done. I'm just going to say that he's blessed me exceeding abundantly above all I could ever hope, ask, or think. And so I've got to turn and come back home and bless those. So, Pastor, I can never, me and Tara can never give you and Tammy enough, but just a little token of our appreciation. We just want to share with the two of you to bless you and in whatever way God sees fit. So whether you want Tammy to take it or whether you're going to take it, okay. I think that when you open that, you're going to probably want to take it back. But okay, but it's for both of y'all. First Lady, it's for both of y'all. Okay, all right, thank you. All right, so I'm going to ask Sister Tammy, go ahead and open it. You see, she ain't shy about opening.
Amen. She gave us $500 gift.
Amen. God bless you. Thank you, man. I can't wait till you come back. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sister. Thank you for this work. Officers of our church come. Thank you so much. I wanted to give him an opportunity to do that. And like I said earlier, those of us that know him, we have to give him a time limit now. Yeah, yeah. That's amen. But thank you for always remembering our church. Amen. Let's continue to worship through giving. Amen. Sister Stephanie, anything you need to say today about the camp or anything? Your way? Oh, okay. All right. All right. Don't text me this evening. Do not text me. I'm telling you now. All right, let's worship through giving. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much, amen, for the opportunity to give to you. We ask that you would accept our gifts. It's in Christ's name we pray, amen. Our ushers are coming, amen. Don't forget to sign up for our camp. Our summer camp will be going on. Amen. We'll be doing a special scholarship towards our camp, amen, later this month as well. Many of you are supporters each year, and you give a special gift. Deacon Thomas and others always give a special gift towards our camp to help families who may not be able to share finances for their children to come. So all of you that do that, thank you so much, but we will be doing that. Amen.
Good morning, church. God is good when? All the time. You know, the pastor always says that God likes a cheerful giver, but this is First Baptist. So First Baptist, will you please tell our guests and visitors in the sanctuary, what time is it? Happy time. So if you please do me the honor of please standing, turn to your right, and wait for the directions of the ushers in the rear as they come to your aisle. Thank you.
Amen. God bless you. Amen. Down through the years, you know the Lord's been good to me. Oh, down through the years, the Lord's been good. I tell you that down through the years, the Lord's been good. He's been good. Good to see you, Brother Tahi. I tell you that all of my days, the Lord's been good. All of my days, the Lord's been good.
Lord, sign me up for the Christian Jubilee. Write my name on the road. Oh, I've been changed since the Lord. Oh, I want to be. Come on. Give this choir a hand as they come. Amen.
Amen, amen.
Didn't it?
God, it's been so good.
God be praised.
God be praised.
Sopranos, God be praised.
God be praised.
God be praised.
God be praised.
Altos, God be praised. God be praised. God be praised. God be praised. Tenors, God be praised. God be praised. God be praised. God be praised. Everybody clap your hands.
God be praised.
Will you help us lift it? Will you help us lift it? Will you praise him in the morning? Praise him in the noonday. Praise him all day long. Will you be going strong? God be praised. God be praised. God be praised. God be praised. God's been good. Can you help us praise? Will you help us lift it? Will you help us lift it? Praise him in the morning. Praise him all day long. Whether you're weak or strong, God has sure been good. God has sure been good. God has sure been good. Will you help us praise?
Amen for the reading of the Word of God. I want to continue our series of messages. I have been sharing a series of messages from the series entitled The Category is Things. And I've shared with you several messages from passages in the Bible that deals with things that shall be added. All things shall be added. Things that are possible. All things are possible. Things that are new. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. Things that should be desired. One thing I desire of the Lord, and that will I seek after. Amen. Go with me this morning to Psalm 150, verse number 6, as we continue this series of messages from the category is things. I just want to lift up verse number 6. Amen. A celebratory message for today. Nothing, amen, deep today. Amen. Just a message that will help us to just celebrate God. This is what the psalmist says in Psalms 150, verse number 6 from the New King James Version. He says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let everything. Anybody in here breathing? That's all I want to know. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want to talk about things that should praise him. Why don't you shout in the atmosphere? The preacher's going to preach about things that should praise him. Give God a hand of praise as I introduce this word. Things that should praise him. The book of Psalms is known as the praise book of the Bible. This praise book is a book that consists of a collection of praises. Throughout the book of Psalms, you can find the writers giving adoration and appreciation to the God that we serve. And in Psalms 150 make up this collection of Psalms that's known as the final Hallel Psalms. The final Hallel Psalms. The Hallel Psalms are the last Psalms in the Bible. From Psalm 146 to Psalms 150, they're known as the Hallel Psalms because all of these Psalms have to do with a hallelujah praise at its beginning as well as its ending. If you will look at those Psalms, you will discover that they begin with the phraseology, "Praise ye the Lord." And then as the writer concludes, he also concludes with the phraseology, "Praise ye the Lord." From Psalms 146 to 150, the opening and the closing phraseology is the same. The psalmist begins by giving God praise, and he also ends by giving God praise. That says to us that regardless of what we have between our beginning and ending, we still ought to give God some praise. You missed it. I said, regardless of what's going on in your life, regardless of what season you find yourself in, it's imperative, it's paramount that you make up in your mind that you're going to continue to give God the praise. Look at what the psalmist says in Psalms 150, verse number 6. He says, "Praise ye the Lord. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord." There ought to be some type of expression of adoration flowing from your lips. There ought to be some type of expression of appreciation flowing from your lips. There ought to be some expectation of an expression of even anticipation flowing from your lip. You ought to praise God with a praise of adoration simply because of who he is. You ought to praise God with a praise of appreciation simply because of what he's already done in your life. You ought to praise him with a praise of anticipation because of what you expecting God to do in your life. Anybody in here believes in praising God on credit? Anybody in here knows you don't have to wait until the battle is over to shout? You can shout like it's already done. You may still be sick, but you ought to shout like he's still your Jehovah Rapha. You may still have a shortage, but you ought to shout like he's still your Jehovah Jireh. You may still be in a storm, but you ought to shout like he's still your Jehovah Shalom. Can anybody just praise God on credit? He says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Things that should praise him. Three things I see in this passage concerning things that should praise him. First of all, Minister Brian, I see an invitation to praise. Let the church say an invitation to praise. Look what he says. He gives us an invitation. And in this invitation, he doesn't write a lot of words, Deacon Nicholson. In this invitation, he simply says, let. He simply says, let. That's your invitation right there. He's not begging you. He's not trying to influence you or encourage you. He just gives you this invitation by saying, let. He says in the text, he says, let. This verbal request that he makes in the form of the word let is saying that you ought to do something or say something to give reverence to the God of glory. That's what he's saying. He says, it's up to you. I can't make you praise him. God is not going to try to make you praise him. But you got to have a led spirit to give God some praise. Because it's up to you whether you open up your mouth and say something. It's up to you whether you raise holy hands. It's up to you whether you pick them up and put them down. It's up to you to give God some praise. So he says, let. He gives us an invitation to praise. And in this invitation that says, let, he goes on to define the type of praise that you ought to be given. And he talks about praising God as a mighty God, praising the might of God. Because in verse number 2, as he talks about it, look what he says. He says, praise him for his mighty acts. Praise the might of God. Praise him for his mighty act. Celebrate God for his mighty acts. We serve a mighty God. One songwriter said, what a mighty God we serve. He's so mighty that angels do what? Bow before him. He's so mighty that heaven and earth, Mackenzie, adore him. What a mighty God we serve. We serve the might of God. He talks about his mighty acts. That has to do with God's power. We serve God because God is a powerful God. And somebody ought to serve him. I'd rather praise him for his saving power. The mere fact that God saved you, you ought to give God some praise. You were on your way to hell. You weren't fit to live. You weren't even fit to die. But God saved you. He was wounded for our transgressions. He saved us, I tell you. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. He was crucified so we could be converted. He died so we could be delivered. He was resurrected so we could be redeemed. You all praise him for his saving power. He didn't have to save you. But you all thank God that you was able to come to him just as you were, weary, wounded, and sad. You all thank God that when you got there, you found in him a rest and play. Anybody in here glad? Just glad to be saved, glad to be delivered, glad to be set free, glad to be washed in the blood of the Lamb? I'm talking about his mighty acts. It has to do with his saving power. His mighty acts. That's what he says in verse number 2, the A part. You're praising him for his mighty acts, his saving power. But I need to also tell you that when it comes to his mighty acts, don't forget about his sustaining power. Don't you forget the reason you're still here. You didn't keep yourself. Oh, to be kept by Jesus. Can I tell you something? I just want you to know. I just want you to know this. I just want you to know that God is keeping me. That's all I want you to know. That God is keeping me. You see me here today, and I want you to know that God is keeping me. I have the same testimony that Israel had in Psalms 124 around verse number 1 when they said, if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side. Is that your testimony? If it had not been. I don't know what's on the other side of your if it had not been. Maybe you saying if it had not been for my popularity, if it had not been for my prestige, if it had not been for my pedigree, if it had not been for me having prosperity, but on every side, on the other side of my if it had not been, it's the Lord. I'm just simply telling you, it's the Lord's doing and it's marvelous. I'm here today because of the Lord. His sustaining power, his mighty acts. I don't have time to talk about all his mighty acts, but I do want you to know about his saving power. I do want you to know about his sustaining power. And I sure enough got to tell you about his supplying power. Everything I have, it came from God. Can I tell you, you're looking at a God did it testimony? Every elevation that I have experienced in life, God did it. Every blessing that I have encountered in life, God did it. I couldn't pull myself up the ladder, but I serve a God who opens up windows in heaven and pulls out blessings that you don't have room enough to receive. God's got a window with your name on it. I said, God's got a win. I told you this was a celebratory sermon. I'm not trying to get deep today. I'm just trying to help you to understand that God is your supplier. David said it like this. He said, I've been young, yet I'm old. Yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed. I'm looking for the seed over here. I'm looking for the seed in the middle. I'm looking, nor his seed begging bread. The songwriter said it like this: be not dismayed. Whatever betides, Jehovah Jireh, God will take care of you. He gives an invitation to praise. He simply says, let. And in this invitation, he talks about praising the might of God, his mighty acts. But then in verse number 2, to be part of that clause, you'll find in this invitation, he talks about praising the magnificence of God. His excellent, I'm not making it up. You read it right. Read it for yourself. You trying to find something to put on your praise agenda. Here it is right here. His excellent greatness. His excellent, that Hebrew word excellent is the word R-O-B. It's pronounced in the Hebrew robe. R-O-B-E in our language, but in the Hebrew, R-O-B, robe, his excellent greatness. His God is robed with greatness. He's clothed with majesty. It's just all over him. His Shekinah glory, it's all on him. It is who he is. It has to do with his excellent greatness. But then that Hebrew word for greatness is the word godel, G-O-D-E-L, which simply means splendor. The splendor of God. The God that we serve is a God of splendor. You don't just walk up on him like you all of that. If you don't believe me, ask Moses. When Moses entered his presence, he said to Moses, hold it, wait a minute, stop. You got to get yourself together, because the ground you're standing on is holy ground. Why is it holy? It's because of the presence of Almighty God, the splendor. You ought to see God even in the midst of your mess in all of his majesty. Did you hear what I said? I said, Lolita, that you need to see God even in the midst of our mess in all of his majesty, his splendor. Praise the magnificence of God. His magnificence is made up of his divine person. The divine person of God. Isaiah talks about his divine person in Isaiah chapter 46, verse number 9. God says to Israel, you need to remember something. He says to them that this is something that you ought to not forget in your life. You ought to not forget that I am the Lord God, and that there's none like me. That's what God told Israel to remember. And I'm afraid many of us have forgotten that there's none like him. I mean, if you believe that there's none like him, he's a priority in your life. He's number one. If can't nobody love you like him, he's number one. If you believe that falling in love with Jesus was the best thing that ever happened to you, he's number one. If your testimony is that can't nobody do me like Jesus, can't nobody do me like the Lord, then you're saying he's number one in your life. God said to Israel, don't forget who I am. That I'm the Lord God and that there's none like me. I'm omnipotent. I have all power. Omniscient. I know everything. I'm omnipresent. I'm everywhere at the same time. Nobody is like him. His splendor is manifested in his divine person, but his splendor, as we praise the splendor of God, the excellence of his greatness, Brother Tahid, is manifested also in his divine perfection. That God is the very nature of perfection. And if you want to know how good you're doing in your life when it comes to you living right, don't measure yourself against your prayer partner. No, don't measure yourself against your pastor. Measure yourself up against God and see how you're doing. And I guarantee you, when you measure yourself up against the perfection of God, you'll find yourself agreeing with Isaiah 64:6 that says, at our best, when we really got it going on, we're nothing more than as filthy rags. We're tore up from the floor. We are messed up. But the perfection of God and his splendor and his glory, we praise him. And then his divine position, because he's high and lifted up. Isaiah said in Isaiah 6:1, in the year the king Uzziah died, I also saw the Lord. I saw him high and is lifted up, his train filled the temple. They were praising and giving glory to God simply because of his divine position, that he's sovereign, that he's in control of everything. Things that should praise him. I see an invitation. It says, let. That's your invitation. That's your invitation. Nothing fancy. Just let. But then I see the individuals of praise. Everything. Everything. He says, let everything. The individuals of praise. Everything denotes every creature, every citizen, every individual in here has a right and a responsibility to praise God. I'm going to let you chew on that a minute, because you may think you're in the not me category. Not me. I'm too cool for that. I'm too quiet for that. I'm too sophisticated for that. But the Bible says, let everything, everything. And in order for you to really be this individual of praise, you have to become a personal praiser. A personal praiser. I'm talking about one who has already declared in your mind, in your heart, and in your spirit that you will praise God if you have to praise him. Am I preaching about anybody? By yourself. I'm talking about a personal praiser. You're not needing the choir to pump and prime your praise pump. You're not waiting on the preacher to prime your praise pump, but you are a personal praiser because you've had some personal encounters. I said, Felicia, back there in the back, you're a personal praiser because you've had some personal encounters. And because of your personal encounters, every now and then you think yourself happy. I said, because he done some stuff for you, you've had some stuff that you had to deal with. Every now and then, you reminisce and you reflect and you think yourself happy. Anybody can say, when I think about the goodness of Jesus and when I think about all he's done for me, I can't help but to praise him. I'm talking about a personal praiser because of a personal encounter. Those personal encounters in your life that have you saying, nobody but Jesus. Nobody but Jesus. I could have been crazy. I could have lost my mind. Listen, I don't even know how I'm really still here, but nobody but Jesus. I thank God for the praise team, and I thank God for the praise ministry, and I thank God for all these talented singers and all of these gifted preachers. But listen, when I think about all God has done for little old me, just tell your neighbor, just tell him as calmly as you can, you don't know. Watch it now. Watch it. You don't know. Don't tell them nothing. Just tell them, you don't know. You don't know. You see me now, but you don't know. Hey. You don't know. In the midnight hour, you don't know. When I didn't have money, you don't know. When I got that doctor's report, you don't know. Hey! You see my glory, but if you only had a glimpse of my story, hey! I'll finish it next week. I said I'll finish it next week. I think this is a good place to close. Just tell them you don't know. Like I know what the Lord has done for me. You weren't there when he brought me out. You weren't there when he opened the door. You weren't there when he made the way. You weren't there when my back was against the wall. I couldn't go to the left, couldn't go to the right, couldn't go up, but I went down on my knees and said, Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help I know. If thou withdraw thyself from me, oh, whither shall I go? Didn't he do it? I said, didn't he do it? Tell somebody he did it for me. And if he did it for me, there's no secret to what God can do. What he's done. What he's done. What he's done for so many others. Hey, hey. He will
Everything that has breath, praise the Lord. I'll finish it next week. On Mother's Day, I'll finish it. Come on, stand with me as we extend the invitation to Christian discipleship. You all have praised your way down here and joined church today. You don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, just praise your way on down the aisle. Praise your way on down the aisle. I'm not talking about the soul train line, but I'm talking about the soul saving line. Just praise your way on down the aisle. Praise Him, praise Him. Sing a little bit of that. As we extend the invitation to Christian discipleship, blessed Savior is worthy to be praised. You've never been baptized. Come on. Praise. 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 Oh, praise. The door is open. Blessed, blessed say, oh, you're worthy. Everybody, everybody on the door of salvation is open to you. You never accepted Christ as your personal Savior. You all are come. Maybe you're already saved and you need a church home. We invite you to come. Blessed Savior, He's worthy, He's worthy. Let's go from the rides and let's go from the ride. Oh, from the. This is your part right here. You all are telling. You all are telling. How worthy is it to be praised? Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. In all things. You all are giving. Give Him glory. Give Him glory. Bless Him. He's so worthy. You may be seated. God bless you. Amen. God bless you. Listen, we're getting ready for our Holy Communion celebration, and If you need to be dismissed, amen, and you need to leave, God bless you. You can leave at this time. God bless you. Thank you so much, Master Sergeant, for being with us, amen, today, amen. I know you all have another engagement. Thank you for worshiping with us on today, amen. As we make ready to celebrate the death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, if you need to be dismissed, you can at this time. Father and our God, how excellent and marvelous and how mighty, how grand and great is your name in all the earth. How we thank you so much for the privilege and opportunity to commune and fellowship with one another. And Lord, we pray your blessings upon this communion celebration, that as we commune together, that you would sanctify this bread that represents your body, sanctify this wine that represents your blood, sanctify us as your children through your forgiveness, cover us with your blood, make us worthy to be able to partake. Bless the fellowship and the celebration. It's in Christ's name we pray, amen.
I know it was the blood.
Oh. Say whatever you want.
Okay. God has smiled on me. He has set me free. God has smiled on me. He's been good to me. Everybody sing, God, smile on me. He has set me free. Oh, God. smile on me. That's it. He's been good to me. Come on, say it from your heart. God, God, smile on me. He has set me free. That's it. Oh, God, God has smiled on me. He's been good to me. Can I say one verse, Pastor? Okay, y'all. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Saved a wretch like me. I once was alone, now I'm found. I was blind, but thank God I can see. Everybody help me say, God, ooh, smile on me. Yeah, he had set me free. Anybody been set free? Wave your hand and shout, God, smile on me. He's been good. Let me say one more verse to me. Yeah.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Save a wretch, wretch like me. I once was lost, but now, right now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Come on, say a verse.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Oh, 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 I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. Oh, 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 God has smiled on me. He has set me free. Anybody been set free? Wave your hand and shout, God, smile on me. He's been good. He's been so good to me. Oh, you know what? Listen to this right here. I came to Jesus just as I was. I was weary. I was wounded. I was so sad. But I found in him a rest in place. And he has made me glad. Throw your hands up and shout, God, God, smile on me. Oh, he has set me free. If you've been set free, you ought to wave and shout, God, hey, smile on me. Watch this right here. He's been good. He's been good. Somebody say, he's been good. Mighty, 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 mighty good. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mighty, mighty, mighty good. Yeah, 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 yeah. Woke me up every morning. Yeah. Shot me on my way. Gave me my health and strength. Let me see a brand new day. Mighty, 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 mighty good. Mighty, mighty, mighty good, y'all. Anybody know he's been mighty good
Touch your neighbor and say, he's been so good to me. So good to me, y'all. I better quit that. So good to me, y'all. So good.
All right, who is that back there? The little one. Where is my little one that's talking to me? Back there. Thank you so much for all of my amen. That's right. That's my amen right there. He's going to be all right. Amen. Thank you so much. Listen, don't forget about our men and women celebration for our Union District Baptist Association Monday and Tuesday. So Brother Melvin and